mentioned, I also mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us big masjid. So how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to accept our faith when masjid is not open for this gathering of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Tell me. I have to ask those people who didn't open the gathering for the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can Allah going to accept their masjid?
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Allah be thanked and praised and glorified over and over again for accepting us as His humble servants and slaves. It is a great joy, a privilege to be here this evening remembering Rahmatul lil Alameen. May Allah Ta'ala bless all of the speakers that eloquently spoke about His blessed countenance, about His blessed ways, about His life. I would like to add to that, I'm not a speaker, but I would like to add to that, how much of that are we implementing? How much of that are we practicing? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Holy Quran Majeed that He is with those and loves those whom enjoin right and forbid evil. He is with those whom stand up for right. Sayyidina Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A mercy to all of creation, all denominations, all races, all creeds. He, rahmatul lil alameen. Witnesses, those individuals, those people, those families, those community and community members whom that zikr that was spoken about, that remembrance that was spoken about, why are we here this evening? What is the purpose? He loves those who revive His sunnah. He loves those who revive His sunnah. Not just speak about His sunnah, but live His sunnah, walk His sunnah, and through their conduct, implement His sunnah. I would like to take this opportunity to invite you all to Holy Islamburg in upstate New York, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's personal name has been shining for over 6 months on the walls of Baytullah, on the walls of Holy Hanukkah, Qajriya, Jilaniya. You can come for yourself and witness and see. This is because of rahmatullah. This is because when we say Adriki, يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم المدد يا رسول الله في سبيل الله. When we say this, when we call upon him, when we call upon him, we are prepared to believe that the cursed shaitan, we do something wrong, we say shaitan made me do it. But then in the same breath we say Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he has died, he's gone. Allah. He is alive. He is alive and he witnesses and he sees. He told the Sahaba Quran, holy companions, even when I leave, those who send salams and salawat upon me, the malaika bring it to me. The malaika bring it to me. I hear it. I receive it. How does he receive it? If he is dead. If he is dead, we are prepared to believe shaitan, the curse, is alive. But rahmatul lil alameen is not alive. He is not aware. When we call on him, he comes. He comes. My nephew, little nephew, had a stomach virus. And he kept on calling on the Holy Last Messenger. And he assisted him and relieved his pain. Whether we are prepared to believe, accept, reject, whatever haq is haq, truth is truth, it needs no difference. I'm so happy to be here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all for allowing us to come. And we will love to participate in the near future, but we invite you to come to Holy Islamburg. And we are Sufis from the Qadri order, Hazrat Ghawth al-Azam, Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, rahmatullah alayh. And our Imam, our blessed Murshid, is al-Sheikh Sayyid Mubarak Ali Shah Jilani, whom is a direct descendant of Holy Last Messenger. We thank you very much. I would like to present a short qasida from Ansar al-Din, the conclusion on Hazrat Zain al-Abideen, rahmatullah alayh, the last standing member of Ahl al-Bayt, whom endured Allah, for the sake of Allah, and allowed Ahl al-Bayt to continue to prosper.
Allah. Thank you.